విశాఖలో జరుగుతున్న సిఐఏ సదస్సులో చంద్రబాబు మాట్లాడుతున్నారు. లైవ్ లో చూద్దాం.
When I took over as CM, within 3 months' time, Hudu cyclone has come. 8 days I was here, I restored normalcy. Today you have seen the city, one of the most beautiful city in India. We made it.
That's true.
It is the power human beings are having. Sometimes we should not carry it away. We have to move forward, study forward. That is my aim.
It is a reflection of vision, Guruji. Vision is very important to drive us.
Correct. You know, vision is absolutely important. Without vision, action becomes a disaster. No, with vision and even in spite of action, there could be some time lapse, as you said. Here, patience really pays off. Impatient people, they cannot achieve anything. Even if they achieve, they don't enjoy it. So, impatience is not just an incident, but it is also an attitude within a person. So for that, one has to take care of it, you know. See, for a baby to be born, it takes 9 months. And if you want the baby to be born in the 7th month, it will have complications.
Right.
So, you must have cultivate patience. See, impatience is one of the sign of stress and mistrust. People have mistrust and stress in their life.
Also inviting Shri Garapati Venu Prasad to please join us on stage and receive the enrollment card from our honorable dignitaries on stage.
Riots and mobs happen in society because of impatience, because of some rumors. Impatient people, they catch on to rumors faster than facts. Because to analyze facts, you need time. You know? So this is necessary. Before you label something or raise a slogan, you must really look into that matter. If something is not happening, why it's not happening, who is responsible, whether we can change it. These are the rational points that one has to think about. Impatient person loses rational, and this is very important for us to cultivate patience. That is where spirituality comes. Spirituality brings patience, perseverance. You don't just give up things very easily. If you have some spiritual practice, you will perceive it. You will see to the end of it. And a third thing it gives is intuitive ability. You know when it's going to happen. You know, impatience is when you're uncertain about the result. But when you're certain about the result, you get confidence. Your patience.
Absolutely.
Same way, I would say the investors who have come here, see, there are, from the past you can see this state underwent many natural calamities. And it's one of the states which just bounced back into action and into resilience immediately, almost immediately. This is an example for people, for investors to see that there is caring in the DNA of the people here. They care for it and they know they want to come back. They want to rebuild the structure wherever there is an issue, there is a problem. We just need these 3 points for us to move forward in any field. One is trust. Trust in ourselves that we will be able to achieve what we want to achieve. Second is trust in the system. India has, even in spite of all its challenges, I tell you, has a very resilient, vibrant system. We have a free press, a very vibrant government, and then we have the courts, which are really trustworthy. So their system. Third is the energy and enthusiasm and resilience of the people with whom you have to work. You know, I'm very sure you have already realized the enthusiasm of youth here. I just want to give you one example.
Sure.
You know, I was in Bhimavaram a few months back in the technology, College of Engineering, the technology, the oldest college of technology. I tell you, the amount of innovation the youths there, they have come up. It's a small town in this coast, not very well known, but the brains that have come out from that is all over the world. Nearly 900 innovations they had come up with, and that brought the pride to other youngsters in that village. Similarly, there is a village here where one youth from every home, every house has joined army, as military. So the talents are in abundance in this region. When talents, resilience and enthusiasm are with youths, I think we don't need to hesitate to move forward.
Sir, you want to add something?
No, I entirely agree with you, Guruji. World is moving different world with the technology. And also disruptive technologies are coming day by day. Innovation is coming not only Silicon Valley, every village. Even as you rightly mentioned, in Bhimavaram, they are able to innovate so many things, which are all global products now. This is where I am always saying, compared to earlier, today we are having so many advantages. If you are having some knowledge or technology or innovation, put it on internet or on technology platform. Use IoT devices. And scale it nationally, internationally, globally, and also locally. It is only an imagination how we are going to give, provide leadership is important. Ultimately, all these things will give opportunities. One should have ethical values.
That's
in
true.
Doing business, ethical values, personal life. If you have that, then your life will be smooth. You will enjoy your life every day. Work is a fun. Or otherwise, every day if you earn any tons of money by going home, so much of stress. You are having tons of gold, or you can eat anything, you are having that facility, or you can engage any flights, but you may not have satisfaction. Now, satisfaction, happiness, stress, how to maintain, it is with you. Every individual has to concentrate what Guruji has said. That is what I am thinking. That's why I am not at all, I am working 10 morning to evening. Except sleeping hours, I will work. I will enjoy my life. I enjoy my work. Work is a fun for me. Nothing will disturb me. When I go bad, 6 hours uninterrupted sleep, nobody can disturb me. That is what I am preaching. If I do right things, I can have a good sleep. I can have a excellent life, nobody can challenge, nobody can do anything, for any individual for that matter.
It's a great point, sir. It's today, and Guruji, I'd like your thoughts, and sir, you also. Today, all of us can live without sleep. We can cut down on our sleep. We cut down on our food. We cut down on our physical activity. We can stop having water and everything. But for 2 minutes, we cannot be without a mobile connection. That is the new oxygen today. 30 seconds, if in this hall there is no mobile connection, we will all be gasping for breath. Why is that? Is technology, which has a lot of good, also making us less human?
It's not the technology at all, it's our attitude. We cannot blame technology for anything. You know, the purpose of technology is to give us comfort. But if we make our comfort as a noose around our neck, it is our lack of understanding, our imbalance of imbalance in our attitudes. So, you know, there is a button which says aeroplane mode, you have to put off. One thing is good, at least if you are traveling in the flight, you turn the aeroplane mode at least while take off and take.
But Guruji, now there is demand to not have aeroplane mode even in the aeroplane. We want Wi-Fi and internet even in the aeroplane. We never want to switch off.
At least it is not it in India. So. Oh, no, but see, at this, I think people who are sort of addicted to any type of technology, I would recommend them to take just 1 week of silence retreat. You have not enjoyed the joy of silence. If you just take even 3 days, 4 days of retreat where you have to keep your mobiles to a side and be cut off from this world, then you have access to another dimension, another world, which is so much more beautiful right there within you. And if you have that experience, then you will find the balance will come in your life. You know when to attend to your phone, when not to attend to your phone. And even without the phone, you can feel how you can have another dimension of communication from within you.
And human-to-human interaction, is that also being impacted? We are always holding the phone, but not holding somebody's hand.
Correct. We need to move away from the virtual world to real world. This is very important. I often recommend kids to not to sit and play the video games, but go out and play with real kids outside. This is important, you know. Even in our education system, it has become a lot of more information rather than interaction. I'm happy that I heard the Central Board of Education is going to cut the syllabus into half yesterday, you know, day before yesterday.